Hi there, this is Teresa Jackson with another creative tutorial for you. While you're here, make sure to subscribe to my channel. And if you're interested in a more hands-on approach to your learning, visit my website, orchardviewcolor.com. I offer one-on-one classes tailored specifically to your learning needs. All right, let's get on with the tutorial. If you are a longtime Photoshop user like me, you may remember using or seeing these natural media bristle brush tips. If you're new to Photoshop since 2018, you might be thinking, whoa, I didn't know Photoshop had natural media bristle brushes. Not only does Photoshop have bristle brush tips like these, it has erodible brush tips and airbrushes too. Before I show you how to find them, let's talk a little bit about what they are. These bristle brush tips act a lot like real-world paintbrushes, especially if you're using a Wacom stylus. Brush settings can be adjusted for the bristle density, length, and stiffness, as well as brush tilt to control the angle of strokes. So you're probably wondering what happened to them and why you can't find them in your Photoshop. Well, in 2018, Adobe removed these from Photoshop's default brush sets in favor of Kyle Webster brushes. But the natural media brushes are still around, and I'm going to show you how to find them. I'm currently viewing the Essentials workspace here in Photoshop. That's the default workspace, but I want to change it to the Painting workspace. So I'm going to go up in the upper right-hand corner here and click on the workspaces and go down here to Painting. This will open the Brushes and the Brush Settings panel, both of what we need for this tutorial. In the Brushes panel, we find four sets of default brushes. Let's look at this first one, the general brushes. These are all your basic brushes, your soft and hard round brushes with pressure or pressure size or pressure opacity. You'll find these options for pressure size or pressure opacity if you're using a Wacom tablet like I am. Now let's look at the other three sets. These are all Kyle Webster brushes, the dry media, the wet media, and the special effects brushes. And if we take a close look at them, they're not even all actually brushes. These are actually tool presets. These tool presets came out in 2018. If we look really close to the Kyle's Paintbox Wet Blender, notice this icon in the upper right-hand corner. It looks different. That's actually the smudge tool. Let's go up to the brush panel options here because you'll want to make sure that you have that icon turned on. By default, it is. That's the one that says Show Additional Preset Info. So if I select that to turn it off, notice those icons go away, and now you really can't tell what kind of tool you're working with if you pick one of these brushes. So I'll go ahead and turn that preset info back on. We'll see that these are brushes. These two are brushes. This is a smudge tool. This is a mixer brush tool. And if we scroll down through here, I think there was an eraser one in here too. Maybe it's up here. Yes, this one here, Kyle's eraser, is actually the eraser tool, not a brush at all. The brushes panel options is also where we find the media brushes. Down here where it says legacy brushes, I'm going to select that and then say OK. And that added a new group to our brushes panel. I'll collapse these so we can see that. Down here at the bottom is the new legacy brushes, or the old legacy brushes. Inside of there are lots more sets of brushes. There's tons of them in here. If we open up the default brushes group, we'll find those same basic brushes at the top. And then if we scroll down, we see a lot of different kinds of brushes. If I select one of these brushes and see how it works, I need a change to my brush tool. Remember when I used one of the Kyle Webster brushes, it was a smudge tool. It switched my tool. So I'm going to go to the brush tool, and then I'll select one of these brushes down here that looks like it has fibers. And I need to make my color black so that we can see it. And now I can create these different kind of strokes based on these fibers that are in here. This is the flat angle. If I take, say, the bristles up, notice in our preview down here, we have a lot more bristles. It's hard to tell in this view that these are natural media brushes. Let's go back up here to the brushes panel options and come down here to show the brush tip. If we turn on the brush tip, it shows us the icon for the different type of natural media brush it is. Let's scroll back up here to the standard ones. Notice we just see The tip is just a circle that has a soft edge for soft round, but if we come down here, we see those tips that I showed you in the opening slide. Notice also that none of these have a tool preset icon in the upper right hand corner, and that's because all of the legacy brushes were created before we had tool presets for brushes. Let's take a closer look here and look at the difference between the brushes settings panel and the brushes panel. I know this is really confusing at first glance. What we see in the brushes panel are a set of brushes that are settings that are applied to a specific brush tip and possibly a tool if it's a brush tool preset. On this side, we have all of the different possible brush tips that are available to us based on the brushes that we have loaded. And then we have a bunch of settings for the tip, and the combination of the brush tip with the settings creates the brush. And if we choose a different tip, let's go to this fan brush. Right now it says flat angle. If I choose this tip, it says that the tip is now the round fan. If I go back to one of the standard tips, like up here, this is just the soft round, I get a completely different set of options for that brush in the brush settings panel. Let's finish this up by finding those other natural media brushes, the erodible tip and the airbrush. I'll scroll down here and we see square charcoal and round watercolor. Both of those have erodible tips. Below that we have the watercolor brushes, and those are actually airbrushes. Let's select the square charcoal brush. Erodible tip brushes like this actually wear down like chalk or charcoal wood. I can demonstrate this better if I change it from a square to a point. Now, notice this is orange because we have changed the settings for this particular brush that's in the brushes panel. And let's take it all the way up to as soft as it can be. And if I tilt my brush or my stylus, you can see that it's showing that it has a point. So if I start to draw, I can actually draw with a pretty sharp point. But as I start to draw more, that point gets worn down, just like it would if I was drawing with real charcoal. And now, no matter what angle I put my stylus at, I'm getting a pretty fat stroke. And I can click on this button here to sharpen the tip. So that's just a quick overview of the erodible tips. You also have these watercolor brushes or airbrushes, and if I select that, we get a completely different set. If I take up the spatter size, we'll see what we get with that. It does look like a watercolor brush, but the settings are more in line with an airbrush. Now that you know a little bit about Photoshop's natural media brushes and where to find them, why don't you give it a try for yourself?